What's up, everybody? Welcome back. I know you haven't seen my face in a while, but it's Deanna here from the Boss Babes. Welcome to our new spinoff, the Boss Babes Banter, which we're going to be doing about twice a month, 1 to 2 times a month, just me and Brittany talking back and forth about our favorite sports and all the action that's going on, maybe some behind the scenes stuff. I know we usually interview people, but we have so much more we want to say and talk about that goes on. So we wanted to start this with you guys. So we're excited to be doing this, traveling a ton. So that's probably why you haven't seen my face. I have my host, Brittany Baldy here still. Brittany, what's up? How are we doing here?
Hey girl, how are you? Thank you so much for joining me today. And obviously all the great fans, thank you guys for listening in to the Boss Babes. I know you haven't seen Deanna in a while. And she came up with this great idea. She was like, you know what, guys? We should do something called Boss Babes Banter where we can kind of just go one-on-one with our fans, with our Boss Babe tribe, and just chat with you all about some of our favorite topics, because you all know that we love sports. We're very passionate about what's going on in the sports world, and we wanted to be able to not only just interview our favorite sports entertainers, but be able to openly talk about some of our favorite topics. So tonight we have a bunch of great topics for you. I know normally we do a show at 8 o'clock at night, but the reason why Deanna and I chose this time was, of course, the Boston Bruins are playing the Carolina Hurricanes at 8 p.m. So that's why we are doing the show a little bit early. Speaking of Carolina, why am I down in Carolina, Deanna?
Brittany, why are you down in North Carolina? I know, I feel like we're playing your new team, but I'm pretty sure you're still a Bruins fan, am I right?
So you guys all know that I'm a big Bruins fan. Obviously, I've been down here in Carolina for the last two and a half weeks, going on 3 weeks now, which is absolutely wild to me how fast the time goes. My boyfriend plays baseball right now. He currently isn't playing, as you guys know. It's a very weird baseball season. Everybody that is typically usually involved with AAA, and they go up and down from AAA to the MLB, they are making the rosters obviously a little bit smaller due to COVID and making sure that people are in more of a bubble. So what he's been doing is training and staying down in North Carolina. I decided, you know what, like, I'm going to pack up my stuff. I'm going to go visit him while he has all this free time, because Deanna knows as well as I know, most professional athletes usually don't have all this free time on their hands. So I took it upon myself to pack up myself and our dog and spend a good chunk of time with him. And it's been a lot of fun. We've been doing a lot of fun outdoorsy things together.
I saw that you guys are out like in this like beautiful like hiking area. Like, tell me about what you've been doing out there. I actually go to Charlotte a lot for work, so I love the area. I know he's not quite in Charlotte, but tell me about like how it's been. How was the drive? Like, give me the whole, like, paint me a picture of how it's been. I've done that drive for a baseball player as well, and it was not as a good of a drive for me, so I would love to hear it if it was any better for you.
I know that you do come down to Charlotte fairly often for work. And I actually remember asking you, like, hey, do you think I should drive? Should I fly? What are some of the best restaurants down here? I think him and I are going to actually venture out to the Charlotte area in the coming weeks. I know we want to check out Lake Norman at some point, which we are excited about. But the drive, actually, believe it or not, wasn't too bad. I think I was more nervous about making the pit stops. Yeah, like, there's a lot of creeps out there and, like, all the sex trafficking news that's been coming out. And I'm small, as you know, so I just made it my point to go out. I bought some mace. I, like, left it in my purse.
I literally got mace,
and I have a baseball bat, like, in my front seat of my car. I was, like, ready. I'm like, if people try to touch me, they're going down strong. But other than that, other than the, like, initial shock of, oh my gosh, I'm driving 13 hours by myself with our dog. You guys have animals. I am telling you, if you were going to do a long trip, you have to pack a lot of treats, my dog had a lot of watermelon.
It was just a very stressful drive with all our stuff. Luckily, we didn't have the dog then. And when we drove down, I had to stop twice. I actually stayed overnight in DC and in Charleston. But I drove down to Jacksonville, Florida, so obviously it was a little bit of a further of a ride. But the hardest trip, like, leg of the trip, was definitely when I hit the Carolinas, because the states are so big. So, like, going through North Carolina, South Carolina, going through Georgia. Georgia's huge, and it just, like, then you finally hit Jacksonville, and you're like, okay, I'm here. Then I had to go to Fort Myers, but that's a whole different story. But I'm glad that your trip was a little more enjoyable, because I was worried that that Decker was going to have a hard time with the ride. So watermelon, that's a great tip. I never even knew that.
Yeah.
It was like a thing that they could eat. So
yeah, I just loaded him up on the watermelon. I felt like it was a good way to give him a healthy treat like every time he did something good, or basically every half hour, I just gave him a little piece. So not only was he getting a treat for good behavior, but he also was staying hydrated because it was too hard for me to turn around and give him water. So that was just my little tip. If you guys go on a road trip with your dog, pack some fruit, pack some watermelon, and it's both good for you and your dog. But I've been down here for almost 3 weeks. We've gone to Hanging Rock State Park. We've been visiting waterfalls and just like playing in the water. Ryan and I recently went kayaking. Spend time outside because it's hot all the time here. Like, that's why my face is sweating right now. I apologize, guys. My face is sweating a little bit.
Yes.
I know it's a little bit hot back home too, right?
Yeah, it's like it's been about a 4 or 5 day like heat hiatus. So it's like 90, 92 right now. It's been hot like this all day. I mean, I've been inside most of the day working, but yeah, it's rough.
Yeah, my dad's been telling me that it's been pretty hot. It's been pretty hot back home as well. And I guess it's pretty similar to what it's been here. The big difference is between here and back home, and we're going to be talking about the Carolina Hurricanes shortly, but I literally know the meaning, Deanna, behind why they call their team the Carolina Hurricanes, because since I've been down here, there has been either a rainstorm every day, even if it's for 20 minutes, or a heat and lightning storm every day. So no matter what, like, there's always some type of rain, some type of lightning. And since I've been here, although I didn't feel it, we've had an earthquake and there's been tornadoes off and on. So the weather down here is definitely a lot different than back home. It's pretty wild.
Welcome to the South.
Right? Welcome to the South.
Yeah. So, but speaking of Carolina playing the Bruins tonight, we're wicked excited. I have my Bruins shirt already on, ready to go. So I'm so excited. They play, I think, tonight at 8. I think game 2 is on Thursday at 8. Then they play Saturday, so that should be a fun game, fun day. I'm really excited. What do you think about the Bruins coming back? I know that they started off as, like, number one, and now they haven't been playing so hot. So what do you think about, them playing Carolina?
Yeah, so I'm actually super excited. I know you guys are listening right now to both Deanna Buonomo and myself. I'm your host, Brittany Baldy. Please subscribe to us on iTunes and Spotify. Of course, we have brand new episodes that usually come out weekly. Please continue to follow us and listen to us on all of our social media platforms. Follow Deanna on her social media as well. She's always putting up some fun golf videos and being active and all that fun stuff. But as far as me and the Boston Bruins, I'm actually kind of upset, and I know you are probably a little bit upset too. Why? We had that three and a half month gap. We were projected to be the one seed, of course, in the playoffs. I think we were number one in the NHL. We had the best, I believe, record in the league. We won the President's Trophy. We were the President's Trophy winners. So coming back and going, I think, 0-3 against Washington is no fun at all. I think having that whole home field advantage per se, or home rink advantage, even though they're in the bubble up in Canada anyway, so it's not like they would be playing in Boston. Going from the potential one seed to the four seed, not looking too pretty. Did you catch any of the games against Washington?
So I caught one of the games against Washington, and they played awful, and I was like wicked upset. So I actually shut it off and didn't keep watching it after that. I just watched the highlights. I've been watching on the NHL app. I've been away, and they don't have all the channels. I feel like everywhere it's been hard for me to like even watch TV at this point. So now that I'm back, I will definitely be tuning into this series for all the games. I did watch the highlights from the Toronto game. Toronto lost, so right now I'm not only a Bruins fan, but I'm actually a Columbus Blue Jackets fan as well, because I'm so happy that they knocked Toronto out. I'm just looking forward to the game. I think it's going to be a good game. The Hurricanes are a pretty good team now, which is funny because they really like weren't a team actually the last couple of years. Looking pretty good. So at least it'll be a good series. I really hope that the Bruins come out on top, because I'd love to see us win. I was there. I think I've mentioned this before. I was there at game 7. I was there at all the playoff games actually versus the St. Louis Blues, and my heart was broken. But the Blues are a better team, so I would just love to see them win this year, even though it probably won't be the same kind of a celebration, but I will celebrate by myself at my house.
I agree with you. Even if we do win the Stanley Cup this year, I feel like it won't be that typical have the duck boats celebrating outside, unfortunately. For example, speaking of teams, and we'll get back to the Boston Bruins, but one of my good friends is the goalie for the Boston Cannons lacrosse team, and they just recently won their championship. Apparently, they all flew down or traveled down somehow to Maryland, and they just somehow combined their whole season into a matter of like a couple of weeks, and they just recently won their season, which is amazing. So they have the trophy back home in Boston, but they're not really getting the opportunity to celebrate because of the whole COVID situation, which is unfortunate. So going back to what Deanna is saying right now, even if we do win the Stanley Cup, I feel like the normal celebrations that we have typically aren't going to be as great. I am looking forward to what happens in the series. As Deanna said, the Canes are doing very well. We're doing very well up until what just recently happened with them coming back from COVID. It's unfortunate. I understand taking that big of a break kind of takes people out of their mojo. But I was looking up some stats earlier, and David Pastrnak, of course, ranks number 3 in the NHL. He has 95 points. Obviously, David Pastrnak is always one of the leading scorers in the NHL.
Yeah.
As far as leading scorers, he always does very well for the Boston Bruins. And apparently, Brad Marchand is number 6. With 87 points. So with 87 points and 95 points, I don't know what these guys are doing, but they haven't really been playing that well. I don't know what's gotten into them. I was kind of joking around with Ryan saying, I don't know if these guys were like partying during that hiatus or drinking too much beer or eating too much pizza because they're not like skating like they normally do. What do you think about that whole situation? You think the hiatus has something to do with their play style?
Yeah, I think it really, I can't speak on their personal lives, but I just feel that maybe it just the uncertainty of are they going to come back? Are they not? Like, if you're not sure you're going to do something, it's like, how hard can you work when you don't even know if you're going to be playing again? And it's like, not that, I mean, I say that's right. I mean, they're getting paid a lot of money to play hockey, so I hope they would always stay a little prepared. But it's just such like an uncertain zone for them right now. So I'm sure at the time they were like, do we work out as hard? Like, should I be training? Should I be doing this? Are we going to be playing? Are we not? And then once they found out they were playing, they probably all just trying to scramble to get it together. And I mean, I don't know. It must be really hard to be a professional athlete right now. Like we don't know. We aren't there. But from what we know and what we see and the people we know, from what I've been told is, I'm just thinking that they're gonna need some time to adjust. And no, I think this is gonna be the series. They're gonna adjust, and we're gonna win, and it's gonna be awesome. I see some people in these comments saying Canes in 6, no can do. I'm saying Bruins in 5.
I agree with you. And actually, Ryan and I had that conversation where it is very hard right now for a professional athlete. You don't know what's happening this season. And for the baseball players, for the even college football right now, we've been sitting there following what's going on with college football. Some teams want to play, some teams don't. And when it comes to the professional athletes, it's one of those situations where it's like, do we just sit on our butts and have our off season and enjoy it? Or do we continue to train because we might get that call, or we might jump into playoffs, kind of like what happened to the Boston Bruins and obviously the Celtics right now as well. So yeah, I agree with you, Deanna. It's definitely been a tricky season, and I feel really bad for all the players, but players like the Bruins that were on top were the President's Trophy winners and basically dominating the whole season, and all of a sudden are the 4 seed.
Right.
What the heck is going on here? They need to pull it together somehow, and they need to pull it together quickly. If you guys are interested in listening in or watching the Boston Bruins tonight, please tune in. I think they play at 8 o'clock against the Hurricanes. Is that correct, Dee?
That's correct.
So 8 o'clock tonight. Obviously, if you guys are back home, I'm assuming the game is going to be up on NESN. Obviously, if you're anywhere else, probably NBC Sports. I'm going to be watching it.
Yeah.
Because I'm down here and it's going to be playing locally, so I'm pretty excited about that. I'm going to get my snacks together.
Yeah.
I'm going to be sitting there. And rooting for the Bruins, of course, even though I'm down here in North Carolina.
I was going to ask you, is anything down there like decorated all Hurricanes? And I feel like here everything has Bruins all over it, even though, you know, no one can be really inside the bars. But people are still like doing stuff like with tables and the restaurants have like Bruins banners everywhere. And the TD Garden's still all lit up, even though no one's in there. Have you seen any like go Hurricanes or anything up there?
So that's actually a really good, interesting question. You want to know what I find interesting, and I've been noticing it since I've been down here. The biggest difference that I've noticed since being in the Carolinas and being back home is they don't support their professional teams like we do up north. Like with us, it's all the professional teams. Even though we have good college teams, we're not really that focused on it. Down here, as weird as it may sound, it's more high school and college. So you go into like the local place to get like an oil change, which is what we just did a little bit earlier before we jumped on the show. You go in to get an oil change or go to like their local food marts or something like that. Everything down here, it's like they're really big with like their Little League baseball. Like everything is like Little League baseball or like Duke basketball. So to answer your question, no, I haven't seen anything Canes related down here at all. Like they're not really promoting it, which is weird because like you said, if you go back home, there's probably Bruins banners everywhere. Yeah. People are rocking their t-shirts like you are. And I think it's just, I mean, I have my home t-shirt on now. I feel like when you're from Boston, it's just like a different vibe.
Right. And it's funny that you said that because now I'm thinking like, every time I'm in Charlotte now, I'm like, wait, like I go through the airport all the time and it's literally just straight up UNC Tar Heels or Duke. And like, that's it, Duke Blue Devils. And it's just all over the airport. I actually don't think I've seen anything about any other sports. And like, they don't have a baseball team, right? I mean, I know Charlotte has a AAA team, but they don't have a professional team in North Carolina. So I'm thinking like, every time I go to Logan, it's like Bruins, Patriots, you know, Red Sox, and they really don't have much professional going on. I do know in South Carolina, they're huge on the Stingrays, which is, I think it's a coast team. And they're like, I went to like two games and it was louder than an NHL stadium. I was like, wow, I can't believe it. And they're like, well, this is the only thing they have down here. Like they don't have anything else and it's right in Charleston. So it's like in a great spot, I guess, for them. But it's just funny to see that. I like college football now.
I think you kind of made a good point with you mentioning that that's all they have down in South Carolina. I actually asked Ryan why they support their high school and college teams more than they do their professional teams. And his reason was apparently they didn't start getting professional teams. I forget the exact year, but they didn't get professional teams for a while. That's why they've always kind of been more into their college teams and their high school teams, because that's all they really had, kind of like what you were mentioning with South Carolina. So I feel like they kind of, maybe it's like a loyalty thing where they're just used to rooting on certain teams. So although they probably value and care for their professional teams, they're more so like all about Duke, all about like their Little League baseball and stuff like that. So it's kind of like a different type of culture down here, which is interesting because even his parents were like, do you guys follow like your college and high school sports? And I'm like, no, not really. Unfortunately, we just kind of follow mostly professional teams back home.
Right.
Because I'm going to switch on over before we get into our other topics. You guys are now listening to The Boss Babes with your host, Brittany Baldy. Of course, you have the lovely Deanna Buonomo. I'm so happy that she's back here with us all tonight. Again, this is a very special episode. We're going to start doing a couple of these a month called Boss Babes Banter. Deanna actually came up with the idea, which I think is amazing because it allows us to talk about fun topics amongst ourselves. And if you guys have any ideas on topics you want to hear us chat about, feel free to DM either one of us, either on our private accounts or on the Boss Babes account. So again, you are now listening to Deanna Buonomo, Brittany Baldy on Boss Babes. But this is a very special episode called Boss Babes Banter. And yes, we are going to still continue to interview professional athletes. Before we continue, I have a very special announcement from one of our great sponsors. They are called Bet Online, guys. And if you know anything about sports, if you like to bet, obviously sports are back. Check out Bet Online. So sports keep coming back. So does your chance to bet on them with our exclusive wagering partner, betonline.ag. Again, guys, that's betonline.ag. Major League Baseball has finally started this summer and is in full swing. There's no shortage of ways to get in on all of the action. Bet Online, again, that's B-E-T online. Bet Online has all the odds, futures, and props for you to bet on. And as sports starts to return, BetOnline has sat down with Eddie George from the NFL, Robert Horry, seven-time NBA champ, and Harold Reynolds from Major League Baseball to get their opinions on what it will be like playing without fans and what they have called the fandemic. Visit betonline.ag. Again, guys, that's betonline.ag today to check out all the odds and up-to-date sports news. Don't forget to sign up and take advantage of all the welcome back to sports bonuses. Bet Online, your online sports wagering experts. So yeah, that's a new sponsor of ours. We are so excited to have them joining us. So thank you guys for listening to Boss Babes. And again, guys, Bet Online is great. Please check them out. And speaking of the Carolina Hurricanes, I know earlier I was joking around about me poking fun at the fact that no matter what I'm doing down here, every day there's rain, Deanna. So right now, if I were to flip this camera around, it just randomly, out of nowhere, skies opened up, it's raining. I swear, it's raining up right now as we speak. It just like comes out of nowhere, the skies open up.
Just pick up and all of a sudden it gets really windy.
Yeah, it's just.
And then it just starts pouring.
it just, the skies get black, it just pours, and it's really weird. But anyways, speaking of other great topics, along with Bet Online, and if you guys are into betting and NHL playoffs, baseball is back, basketball is back. Have you been following any of the Boston Celtics? Or I haven't really been keeping up with it that much. And it's funny because I mentioned to Ryan that I feel like I'm not into it that much right now because we had such a hiatus and everything's been so up in the air that it's almost hard to like get back into the swing of things with sports.
Yeah, I would actually say that. I couldn't agree more. It's not that I like don't care for sports more. I actually picked up golf, which I think a lot of you have seen in my videos and anything on my personal Instagram. I picked up golf because it's something I've always wanted to play and I've always wanted to be good at it. I actually have my first lesson on Thursday, so I'm excited. I've been playing a little bit and I just feel like I'm so fixated on like just picking a new sport and like being around something I can play during a pandemic. And like, I just haven't even been thinking about watching anything really. I did watch some of the Red Sox game last night. It went on way too long for me and they ended up losing, which stinks. But it's just like weird for me to remember to put a sports game on. I haven't, my TV is behind me. It has not been on in months, like just not even on. Like just nothing to watch. So I don't watch TV, I watch sports. And now that everything's back, I've been kind of just trying to get back into like a habit of putting the TV on and having Nessun just run all day.
I agree with you. It definitely has been weird trying to get back into the swing of things, especially with those winter sports playing in the summertime, because it's one of those things where even me, like, I don't really want to watch ice hockey games or basketball in the summertime. I'd rather be outside and grilling and watching a baseball game, like at a bar or while I'm swimming with like an outdoor drop down freaking screen or something, like projector screen. And no one wants to do that during, like 90 degree weather, you know, because we both follow the season. At this point, players are still in the off season. Usually the NHL awards are already complete, but it's weird to see them in playoffs right now.
Yeah. I'm like, I wouldn't mind summer hockey if anything was open. I'd be excited if I could be like outdoor in a patio watching it. Like maybe you should get on the Cape and hit up the courtyard with the Bruins. There's a spot to watch it. If you guys are from Massachusetts, go down the courtyard. I bet you they have it outside on a projector.
We need, send us some ideas, guys. If you have ideas where Deanna and I could be watching these games outdoor.
Yeah, where to go.
But we're going to switch on over, talk about some other topics. But again, Boston Bruins tonight, 8 p.m. on Nessun if you're back home, or NBC Sports. They're playing the Carolina Hurricanes. We hope they come out on top because they've kind of been stinking up the house. But I could see them coming back. So fingers are crossed. But let's switch on over. So babies and engagements. We know Deanna and I love talking about sporty entertainment. That's what this whole show is based on. Sports and entertainment. So Conor McGregor, one of the best UFC fighters, but he's also one of those people that likes to play games. He likes to go into retirement, come back from retirement, go back into retirement and come back out again. And it looks like he's kind of doing the same thing with his love life, because what did we learn, Deanna? That he's been dating the same girl since 2008. They have two kids. 12 years later, he decides to pop the question. What the heck is that all about?
I know. I'm not mad about it. I'm excited for them. So congratulations. But 12 years, I'm like, wow, okay. Like, I didn't even realize they weren't engaged, because I just would assume they were married, like with two kids. And I understand that it's like totally okay to unconventionally have all this stuff going on, but money isn't a problem. You know, time doesn't seem like it's really a problem. She's always by his side, which I love. So I'm just surprised that he didn't pop the question sooner, but maybe they were just waiting for a special moment. So, but that's awesome for them. Like, congratulations. I'm sure Dee's really excited.
It's kind of cool that they maybe waited so long. I mean, I feel like professional athletes, when it comes to picking their wives and girlfriends, which you and I are going to have a whole separate banter on that in itself, I feel like wives and girlfriends are in like a separate category when it comes to women, if that makes sense. Like, I feel like guys are, especially professional athletes, are very picky with who they decide to date and have kids with and settle down with. So maybe Conor McGregor was like, you know what? I want to make sure that this girl is with me for me. Can you guys hear that thunder?
I can hear that. Wow.
And I am covered, so don't worry about me. But yeah, I do feel like Conor McGregor is probably one of those people that wanted to make sure that he was financially stable with the right girl for the right reasons. And I mean, obviously Dee Devlin is the one. I think Deanna kind of had a story where she thought that maybe she found him on the streets or something. Deanna, what was that story that you were telling me earlier?
I don't know if I even saw it. It must have been on like one of those like goal cast things on Facebook. I don't know how true it is, so please don't quote me on this. But I did hear that they met when he was like a very young, when he was like 19 or something. And I heard that he was like borderline homeless at the time and she took him in. So while he was training, his family like wasn't really about him being a boxer. I think they wanted him to like go to college and get a job. And I think he was a plumber at the time and he was like, no, I want to go train. I want to do this. I think she kind of took him in. Maybe he wasn't homeless. Maybe that's like where the false part of the information is. But I'm pretty sure she took care of him while he was trying to become a boxer and helped him with like the bills and stuff to pay for that. And like, you know, obviously, hopefully didn't pay like for rent or anything. She probably like took him in. So I don't know. She definitely seems like she's a huge part of why he is where he is. How true it is, I don't know. But maybe we'll look it up and we'll get you the answer next time.
That sounds pretty interesting to me. And it honestly doesn't really seem that far-fetched because from what I understand is obviously he's from Ireland. From what I understand, she's also from Ireland and she grew up down the street from him or down the street from his hometown. So it does kind of sound like maybe they had mutual friends or maybe they bumped into each other off and on, or maybe they even had some type of a friendship before they started dating. So if what you just mentioned about Conor McGregor is true, I think she is fully deserving of that ring, fully deserving of being the mother to his children. And I can't wait to see what her wedding dress looks like, where they decide to get married. Where do you think that they decide to get married? Do you think it'll be here in America or go back to Ireland? What are your thoughts on their potential wedding?
I feel like it would probably be back in Ireland since they're both from there. I mean, I'm sure they want to be around all their family and friends. And I don't know. I doubt they all live over here. So I would say probably in Ireland. Maybe they'll go back to their hometown where they met.
I think that sounds like a really good guess that they would probably go back home, especially if they have family back there and whatnot. Again, guys, Conor McGregor, he recently got engaged, I believe over the weekend, which is super cool, to his longtime girlfriend, Dee Devlin. They do have two kids together. Took a long time to pop the question, but we are very excited to see what unravels from that. Please stick with Deanna and I. I'm sure we will give you guys updates as we go. But speaking of engagements, I absolutely love this couple. I know you do too. Lindsey Vonn and PK Subban. They got engaged around a year ago. I think it might have been around this time last year. He popped the question, I believe, last summer. And she also popped the question to him, I believe, this winter. And I think it's really cool that they both have engagement rings right now. And Lindsey got a really special engagement ring. It wasn't your typical like white diamond or anything that. Apparently it was some type of an emerald green type of stone because it's his birthstone color and it's her favorite color. So we might have to go look up her engagement ring, but apparently it's an emerald green color. They've been engaged and dating for a while. And yeah, what do you think about them getting engaged? I mean, she's a former Olympic star, gold medalist, skiing, amazing champion, and he is obviously a very talented NHL player. So we know that their kids
are going to be athletes and a half.
So, and if they don't turn out to be athletes, you know, something went wrong somewhere.
They're like fashion designers, if not. They're both like very fashionable, if you haven't noticed.
They are very fashionable. They do both have great personalities. I've been watching them. They do something really funny called Hot Tub Time or Tub Time. On YouTube, it's like a whole series where they sit and interview and like chat in the hot tub with their dogs, like in the bathtub.
Well, how do you sound so fun? They seem really entertaining. And didn't you mention earlier that like Lindsey Vonn is coming out with a new show?
Yeah, so Lindsey Vonn actually is coming out with a new show. If you guys are interested, up right now, it's called The Pack. So Lindsey Vonn, along with her dog Lucy, who's super cute, she has a couple dogs, she's a big dog lover, she's coming out with a brand new show. I think it's coming out the end of the year and she's teaming up with Amazon. But it's going to be a competition series with 12 contestants. I'm not really too sure what the logistics are yet. They haven't dropped all the info yet. It's still very new. But apparently these people are going to be competing for up to $500,000 and up to $250,000 will go towards their favorite animal charity. So not only will the winner win money, but they also get to choose where their $250,000 goes towards their animal charity. So I'm excited to see what the show is going to be entailing. I know that it involves animals. I know that it involves some type of competition. And yeah, what do you think about her new show, The Pack? Again, there's not much info out there about it, but it sounds pretty rad.
It sounds like a great idea. I was going to say, Brittany, like maybe you should go on it. Like it's kind of like a challenge. You've already dominated and done a great job at a show like just like it. I say you get yourself on there. Decker would appreciate it.
The meta actually be kind of cute. Like Decker and I just going on there and competing. I might have to watch a season of it and see what it's about. But yeah, maybe I can get him and I signed up.
How cool would that be?
That would be pretty badass. You guys are now listening to Brittany Baldy. Obviously, I'm your host with the lovely Dana Bonomo. You guys are listening to The Boss Babes. Please subscribe to us on Spotify and iTunes. Here we go right here. Spotify, iTunes, if you guys aren't listening to our episodes, they all get posted up there. And as you know, we do put up special edited versions of each one of our shows up on YouTube as well. Hockey, we talked a little bit about baseball. We talked about my trip. And we're going to be talking about some baby announcements shortly as well. But I know this isn't that great of a topic, but because it's kind of negative. However, we have to discuss it. Okay. What the heck is going on with Kristen Cavallari and Jay Cutler? As you guys know, Kristen Cavallari used to be a MTV star. She was on The Hills and Laguna Beach. And then she was also married to retired quarterback Jay Cutler. They also had multiple seasons of a TV show called Very Cavallari on E! I absolutely loved the show. It was great watching their dynamic unfold on TV. What do you think about this whole freaking divorce? Like, why do you think it's happening? My theory is because there was like a rumor going around that he actually hooked up with one of her best friends. Okay. Don't know if it's true or not, but that was kind of the rumor that was circulating, and she was kind of like dodging those bullets online. And shortly after Easter Sunday, she randomly put up a post saying that after 10 years that they were getting a divorce. So what do you think is going on with that whole situation?
I don't really know. I guess, like, if I could be all transparent, I never watched Laguna Beach. I never watched any of those shows when I was growing up. So I wasn't a big Kristen Cavallari fan. I actually like her shoe line that she has. So I'm like, that's the only thing I really knew about her. And then when the divorce happened, I actually started looking into it because I was so curious. So I was like, wait, I feel like they've been together for like 10 years. How did they just get divorced? So just out of curiosity. And I was like, wait a minute. And then the next thing I know, a picture of her and Stephen Coletti, I think is his last name, the guy from Laguna Beach. The only thing I remember from Laguna Beach is the fact that her and Stephen were together. And then I actually just watched all 9 seasons of One Tree Hill and Stephen was on it. So I was just curious and I was like, wait a minute, are they back together? Has anyone confirmed it?
I've been trying to follow that too, because like you, I saw her put up that post like a week or two ago and I was like, wait a minute, are they actually dating? I know that they kept their friendship because on Very Cavallari, she did talk about the fact that her and Steven were still pretty good friends. Mm-hmm. I mean, you have to think like they kind of grew up together in the same area. They dated for a while. So I think they kind of just like kept that friendship. I don't know if she's like actually dating him again or if she put up that photo as like a slap in the face to Jay to be like, haha, if you want to mess around potentially with one of my friends behind my back, I'm going to get back with one of my exes just to rub it in your face. I don't really know what's happening, but for Boss Babes banter, it's some good tea.
Good tea, but also bad tea because I feel sad about it. But I'm also just so curious. I wish I knew what happened, because if anyone actually knew the real story, then at least I'd understand like why these pictures are going up. I'm not really one to like play a game, but I totally wouldn't blame her at that point. And also, speaking of sad news,
I know,
like so many things. I said we were going to come on here and talk about engagements and babies. Now I just like, I'm just thinking of all these other divorce things I'm seeing that are just so bizarro. And I just don't know if anyone else has been worried about this stuff, but Vanessa Morgan and Michael Kopech.
Yes.
With that, I see a pregnancy announcement and it's just her in the photos. And I noticed that she wrote like, I cannot wait to welcome this baby. So now I'm like, what do you mean? Did you just inseminate yourself? Like, I don't understand. So I looked into it and saw that he filed for divorce the day after she posted it.
I had no clue about that. So to give you guys some backstory, if you guys don't know who Vanessa Morgan is, she's a big time actress, very pretty woman. She's a big Riverdale star. She's done stuff with MTV. And her and Michael Kopech, who is one of the top prospects in baseball, he's a pitcher. Deanna and I were discussing it earlier. He actually was involved with the Red Sox organization for a little bit. I believe now he's with the White Sox organization. I think he opted out of the season this year for X, Y, and Z reasons. But the fact that he literally was already dating a reality TV star, he was with Brielle Bearman. So Michael Kopech was dating reality TV star Brielle Bearman of the TV show Don't Be Tardy for a very long time. They were very young and they ended up breaking up for whatever reason. And I find it really interesting that not only did he get married very young, but he popped the question what seemed to be almost a few months after his breakup with Brielle. So that's kind of like a bunch of tea in itself.
And they met on Instagram. So they probably didn't know. It's not like they had this like background friendship I think they talked online for a while, but they never really were like knew each other that well. And then
five months later,
they've only been married for 5 months.
I know. Apparently, Vanessa Morgan, again, I don't know either one of these people directly. It's more of, obviously, I keep up with this stuff because I love sports and entertainment. But I've read that Vanessa Morgan DM'd Michael Kopech. That's how they started talking, started dating. But I remember saying to Ryan, like, wow, Kopech is pretty young to be getting married. I don't see that happening. And then you're right. Let's get back to, like, this freaking tea of her having a pregnancy announcement. I thought that it was Michael's child because they're married. And then you hit me with the, Britt, did you see that they're getting divorced? And I'm like, whoa. So did she cheat? Is it his kid?
Yeah.
Like, what is going, did she artificially inseminate herself? And maybe he doesn't want a child yet. Like, what do you think is going on?
Like, I literally have no idea. I like couldn't even think about it. I was trying to figure it out at first. Like, I think I like went into a vortex hole of like just sitting there when I just scrolling and scrolling through like this conspiracy theories. But at this point, it's like, how do you know? Like, I wouldn't even want to take a guess because I feel like it's like starting a rumor. But I mean, hopefully they either work it out or they are, if it is his baby, which I would hope it was, maybe they can amicably co-parent and, you know, the baby can grow up with a good life. At least, you know, they're financially stable. So at least maybe we'll be good there. But yeah, that's like, that's hard. I mean, I can't imagine going through that and having to publicly be in the public eye. It's one thing to go through it. Nobody know, but it's really hard. Yeah, I feel bad for them actually.
Have your whole life out in the public with like TV shows and going to award shows together and whatnot and having such an open life to potentially getting divorced, just like Vanessa and Michael Kopech. It's one of those things where when you're in the public eye and you go through that divorce, it sadly everybody talks about it and you have to post about it because your life is so public, which is sad situation. I feel bad for both of them. Hopefully things end up turning out the way that God wants them to be. And I'm sure things will turn out the way that they should. But let's talk about something a little bit more positive. So our friend Mariah recently got married. What was it, last summer or the summer before that?
Last November.
Mm-hmm. So we'll have Deanna give some backstory on Mariah Shepherd. She's good friends with her. So Mariah recently got married last November in the fall. Thank God she did it last year, not this year, because obviously there's no COVID.
Yeah.
She recently got married and she's pregnant. I think about to be giving birth soon. So I'll have you talk a little bit about Mariah. She is absolutely adorable. They live out in Arizona and her husband actually plays for the Baltimore Orioles.
Yeah. So I've been keeping in touch with her here and there, just trying to make sure she's feeling okay. I know. I remember when we used to, 2 years ago, we basically lived together. Her husband was my roommate, was my ex's roommate. And like, they are just the cutest couple in the whole wide world. Like, I love both of them so much. And she was telling me how, like, he had just got called up randomly. They weren't sure. So obviously, as you know, with Ryan, like, you guys are not sure if he could just get called up any moment really to play. And they got a call. So they went out to Baltimore for a couple weeks ago. And she is getting really close to the end goal. So they're pregnant. I knew they wanted to have a baby right away. So they were so excited. And she said she's doing good. She said it's obviously difficult, but I'm really excited for them. And I can't wait. They're having a little girl. So I'm so excited to see what comes of that. I mean, I feel like a lot of people have gotten engaged within the last year too. Teresa, my friend Teresa and Colton Brewer, they just got engaged. I think it was within 6 months ago. And the ring's beautiful. They just did a really cute photo shoot. So yeah, it looks like all the girls are getting their rings. And I love that because all the boys got their rings last year. So I'm really happy to see that.
Very exciting. I'm really excited for Mariah. I'm excited to see those baby photos. I've been following her whole journey up on Instagram. She looks absolutely stunning as a pregnant lady. Like, if I could see a pregnant woman like look good, I don't know how these women do it, but she looks absolutely stunning and she looked gorgeous in her wedding dress too. She's a very amazing woman. You guys can follow her up on social media as well. Follow her. She puts up a lot of great photos of her dog and her pregnancy and wedding. Photos. Obviously, she just recently got married. But yes, please continue to listen to the Boss Babes, guys. We are doing Boss Babes banter right now. We have Brittany Baldy here and Deanna Buonomo. Who else we want to talk about? Mike Trout. Obviously, big MLB star. Baseball season is back. I actually thought he was going to opt out of the season because his wife was pregnant with their first child and with him not knowing what was going to happen with the bubble, if they were going to have a bubble and not be able to see his child be born. I honestly thought he was going to opt out. He ended up being able to see his wife give birth, and I'm super excited. I think it's really cute that it's their first child they found out that she was pregnant right around Thanksgiving of obviously this past year. His initials are BAT, Bat.
How cute.
Beckham Aaron Trout. You think he did that on purpose, or you think it's just coincidence, or what are your thoughts on Mike Trout having the initials for his first baby boy be BAT?
I don't know. I'm wondering if the name Aaron has like any significance, whether it's like somebody's like father, like her father or his father, or if maybe it was like his middle name. We'll have to look that up. But other than that, I think like that's like too much of a coincidence for it to just be a coincidence. Like, that's so cute.
I agree. I never
thought of that. Like, that's adorable.
Like, he did it on purpose. And if he didn't, I mean, we're starting to pick up on it. So it's a cool little, what is it, an acronym? BAT.
Yeah, like BAT. Like, pick up that.
Pick up your bat.
That, so, I mean, definitely would make sense.
Yeah, maybe they did do it on purpose, but I think it's super cute. Their baby is adorable. If you guys are interested in seeing a photo of Mike Trout's baby, obviously you can look up on his Instagram or the Boss Babe's Instagram. I just recently posted up a photo of their newborn son up on our Instagram as well. So please feel free to check that out. And Evander Kane, big NHL star. I didn't even realize that he had a wife. I thought he was just dating somebody, but he made an announcement back in July that he and his wife gave birth to a baby girl named Kensington, did her whole baptism and all that. And I'm pretty excited for him. I don't know if he's in the playoffs or not right now. I haven't really seen him posting about it or not. So I would assume that the Sharks probably aren't in the playoffs. Don't quote me on it. Again, I haven't been following the NHL as much since the whole COVID situation has been going on. But I am very excited that they welcomed a baby girl into the world. And I wonder if he's going to teach him or her, should I say, how to play hockey. Do you think she's going to be an NHL player? Well, obviously not an NHL player, but do you think she's going to play hockey? Do you think she's going to be a field hockey player? What are your thoughts on her potentially being a potential athlete?
I don't know. I mean, I think maybe it depends on like, I actually don't know what his life looks like. And if she's, you know, shorter, she comes from a family with some height or what, I'm not sure actually, but I do think that all these guys have a potential to have a child who could be an athlete. Maybe she'll be like a Lindsey Vonn. Like, who knows, you know, like it's just so exciting. I'm like excited to follow their journeys and follow like the growth of their children. And it's just like really cool to see. And like, I wonder like in 10 years, you know, even 20 years, like we're going to be older. We're going to be older and we're going to be watching and being like, wow, like that's so-and-so's kid. Like, so I don't know. I mean, excited for them. Hopefully she's like in the Olympics or something cool.
You are hoping that you pop out a professional athlete. I hope that I do too. We don't know what sports our future kids may or may not play, but I feel like that's always kind of the goal when you're, if you are dating somebody athletic, you hope that those genetics do get passed on, have a little bit of athleticism. So that way they are not only athletic, but I feel like it's a sign of good health as well.
Of course, makes it a little easier. And the kids are going to be like, let me go lift at the gym. Like, you just got to get them active and run around. And yeah, I mean, that's the goal, right?
That is the goal. And you guys, again, are listening to The Boss Babes with Brittany Baldy and Deanna Buonomo. We are so lucky to have you guys listening in. We love our Boss Babes tribe. And before we wrap up the show, we just wanted to talk a little bit about some positive pop shortly. I'm going to have Deanna talk about some positive pop that she has been seeing, I believe, go on in the NHL. And I want her to give me some positive pop, maybe that's been getting her through the summer or what she's been up to as well. Before we get into that, next week, guys, August 18th, we have a very special guest. I don't know if Deanna is going to be co-hosting with me or not. I will ask her after the show. But joining me live will be Mercedes Brooks. She is actually an LSU recent grad. She played college basketball, and she's also dating Tremont Waters of the Boston Celtics. So August 18th, next week, live with us, or potentially just me, is going to be Mercedes Brooks, LSU grad and female basketball player, and dating Tremont Waters of the Boston Celtics. So you know we're going to be getting some basketball info out of her, seeing how they met, seeing what it's like playing college basketball, and their relationship. So please stay tuned with that. Deanna, hit me with some positive pop. How's your summer been? What's going on in the NHL? Or what you've been following, what types of stories, and what is some of your own personal positive pop that you've been using to get yourself through this not so typical summer?
Okay, so let me start with I have like an NHL and MLB positive pop, because it kind of just, they're the same thing really. But I did notice right when the NHL players all got to their hotels, it was so nice. The NHL did is they put pictures of their families all over the hotel room, their kids, their pets, their girlfriends, wives. They put them all over the hotel rooms, which probably made it feel a little bit more like home, because I believe with the NHL, I don't believe they're allowing any of their wives to be with them right now. With MLB, they do allow their wives to live with them. And they have actually put all cardboard cutouts. So if anyone's seen any baseball games and seen the random cardboard cutouts, I think people just thought they were random pictures of random fans. They're actually not. That their families, their dogs, their wives, their parents. They put pictures of all of their family all over the stadium so that they can feel like they're there. And I saw Sarah Esposito and Mike Chavis posting a couple pictures of them. And it's just so cute. Sarah is one of my really, really good friends. And Michael Chavis is an awesome, awesome guy. So they just put some funny pictures up the other day of Sarah and their dog, and Mike's just in there with the family. So I just thought that was cute. It's a great way to give the players something back, because I do feel for them on the level that, you know, a lot of people aren't working right now, and they kind of are essentially owned a little bit and need to have to work. So they're there to entertain us. So it's nice that they were able to give back and give them something. And then for me, like I said earlier, I picked up a new sport. I'm excited for golf, and I want to get really good at it. And hopefully I'll have something new to look forward to. I used to play softball, but they are actually currently tearing up the field I play on. I've been able to find another team to play with. So that has been getting me through the summer, just trying to stay athletic. I've been running, keeping myself as zen as possible, which is so hard these days. But yeah, that's basically my positive pop.
My biggest thing is meditation. Like Deanna mentioned, staying zen. And getting outside, being active, being in that sunshine, and being around good people, because that's the only way to stay positive, especially during the tough times right now.
I feel like we're the same. I was like just about to think about it and say something else, and I was like, no, we're literally the same person. But that is why we're here on Boss Babes Banter. So guys, thank you so much for tuning in with us.
Thank you so much for tuning in. And before we go, actually, not that I forgot, but I want to wish Deanna a happy birthday. She just recently... Yeah, you recently celebrated your birthday like a week or two ago. Was it last weekend or the weekend before?
It's July 31st, so a little under 2 weeks ago.
Awesome. So Deanna just recently celebrated her birthday. So let's congratulate her and celebrate her. I know that I made a
trip around the sun.
Another trip around the sun. So happy birthday to you, Deanna. Again, thank you so much for joining me today. Everybody, thank you for tuning in to us on the Boss Babes. We are going to be back again August 18th. So please join in. And of course, Deanna and I will be doing more Boss Babes Banter. So if you have topics for us, feel free to DM us either separately or on the Boss Babes Instagram and send us your comments. Let us know if you liked what we talked about today. And we can't wait to see you guys again soon.
And go Bruins.
And go Bruins.